Welcome back. We're live here at the March on Wall Street, and joining us now is a man who at one point was the largest oil trader in the world. He is the founder and CEO of MBF Clearing, which may mean very little to you, but I can tell you he has been and continues to be not only one of the most honest and effective traders I've ever seen in my life, but he is also one of the most insightful and interesting personalities I've ever met. I had to coax him onto the television. But I did. Senator Coburn and Richard Trumka both said the real problem here is the Congress. Do these people have the wrong, are they in the wrong place?
You know, I applaud everyone's efforts of coming out today. But this is a lynch mob lynching the wrong person.
And explain why you think that.
The rules that the banks work under are not set by the banks. The rules are set by our government. If the government goes ahead and allows leverage to be ad infinitum, if the government allows the AAG of the world to write credit after credit with no collateral behind it, is it AIG's fault? Is it Goldman Sachs? It's not their fault. It's the people who are writing the rules. And obviously the people who are writing the rules need an education in how to write the rules better.
So how do you achieve that?
You achieve it by going ahead and getting, really, Wall Street, a group of people from Wall Street themselves, along with academia, who knows a lot more than the politicians do, to write effective regulation. To say, you know what, if you're a bank, this is the most leverage you're going to be able to be with your own capital. If you're using government debt, you can't trade with government debt. You know, you just cannot trade with people's money.
No jobs, no future.
See, I'm listening to these people, and they're lynching the wrong person.
But this is where we're headed. Is you've got people that are understandably angry as this crowd goes for blocks up this.
I had to try to get through it.
And so, how do you take the energy that is building in this country and has been for years, the frustration with the feeling of unfairness, which is really what these people are responding to, is they feel that the system is unfair and not directed at the wrong place, but directed at a place that actually helps America and fixes the problem? How do you do that?
First of all, I don't want to be seen as just defending Wall Street.
Of course. No, brothers and sisters.
But without Wall Street,
today,
right?
I'm here
most of these
I'm
people
that
these people work for, they don't have
Explain
jobs.
Explain why that is. Explain how important Wall Street is to the day-to-day function when it works.
Because the capital that Wall Street raises, right, creates the infrastructure, creates the jobs, creates the projects, creates the bonds,
the buildings
that these people are working for.
Right. So we know how important Wall Street is because it is the very spine, the very backbone of our economy. However, there's a sense that spine has been corrupted by a few people and the government, not to support the economy, but to take money out of the economy through infinite leverage at places like AIG. Is that a fair perception?
It's sort of fair. What's more fair saying is you need rules written by the people, for the people, or in this case,
what would be the guiding principle for those rules? And then I'll wrap this up.
Guiding principle would be number one, okay? When parents limits lose on capital credit for everybody, work, banks, traders, everybody. Number one. Number two.
It reaches into my classroom. And not
everything
just
being
my
a transparent, regulated thing. And if you're a bank, okay, and you're acting as a principal,
students,
make sure your counterparty knows that you're dealing with them. Okay,
this country's going in the wrong direction. Yeah.
Mark, I can't thank you for coming into the belly of the beast.
I mean, I just feel bad because I look around and these people all have well intentions, but they're directing it at the wrong.
Let's make sure
they're going to Washington D.C. And I'm talking to them, and they understand that. Richard Trumka was saying that, who's the organizer. They want to go to Washington D.C. as was Senator Coburn.
You asked me one last question.
Yeah.
How does this message get delivered to the people?
Yeah.
In reality,
hello,
the best
everybody.
Person I know to deliver this message is standing right next
to
me.
Well, listen, you're nice to say that.